6 days from WrestleMania with a huge show planned on Raw for the competition, WCW had its annual spring break edition of Nitro. With the subtle Ric Flair heel turn developing since the uncensored pay-per-view, the show was built on Flair defending the world title against a lottery pick opponent, along with Goldberg against Sandman and a Miss NWO contest. In a segment at the top of the hour, Flair initially told J.J. Dillon that he's taking the night off, but then changed his mind telling Dillon to pick a random number and he's challenging anyone in the company, Goldberg to Hogan to Bret to the Outsiders, any match is possible. Before ending up telling Dillon to make sure there are only mid-carders and cruiserweights in the vote. On the final step of arguably the greatest road to WrestleMania of all time, the company promoted Raw on March 22 to be the biggest in history, hyping the main event of the first ever Steve Austin vs. Paul Wight match as the biggest match in show history, with major promotion all week on the USA Network to what was targeted to be a record-breaking night with momentum at a peak. The corporation opened Raw with the final hype to Mania, with Vince introducing The Rock and Shane, and saying that both will leave WrestleMania with the belts. Shane, who will make his in-ring debut in 6 days, challenged X-Pac to a Greenwich Street fight for tonight, planning a surprise for him in the parking lot. Rock hyped the Mania main event with Vince announcing him to be the special referee for the Austin Giant match tonight, bringing out Foley who challenged Rock for one more match between them, forcing him into the match with a signed contract from Shawn Michaels. Moments later, Steve Austin driving a beer truck entered the arena to a huge reaction, giving the final promo for the Mania main event before spraying the corporation with beer in one of the greatest segments of all time. With Raw already opening at near record levels with a 6.4 rating, the near 20-minute segment then grew to a 6.9. Wight interfered in the Rock Mankind match, causing Rock to lose by DQ, putting Foley as the special referee in the main event for tonight, with Mankind and Big Show scheduled for a match at WrestleMania with the referee spot and the Rock Austin match on the line. WCW peaked with a 4.1 for the Miss NWO segment, putting over Torrey Wilson, along with the Goldberg vs. Hack match. The segment was usually done to pick Miss Nitro on the spring break shows, but this time Nash and Hogan brought a group of fitness models in a segment designed to put Wilson in the spotlight as WCW's answer to Sable, who was on the cover of the highest-selling Playboy magazine while also featured this week on a cover of TV Guide along with Rock, Austin and Foley. During this segment, Nash also took a shot at Sable, comparing her to Wilson. With rumors about a legit heat with Nash and several others, Bret Hart came to the ring for a promo with Mean Gene, indirectly addressing it and making several semi-shoot comments on Nash, Hogan and Goldberg. When asked about the dream match with Hogan that was supposed to be the main priority when signing with the company, Bret responded saying that he lost patience and don't think it will ever happen. Nash was next, as Bret said that Nash might be the pencil, but he can be the eraser, referring to Nash's role as a booker. The final one was Goldberg. Bret said that Goldberg never wrestled anyone on his level and he can beat him in 5 minutes. With Nitro coming from Toronto, Canada next week, a big Hart vs. Goldberg confrontation was set for the show. With the industry at all-time peak and seemingly breaking new milestones on a weekly basis, including on this night, every major channel and publication was covering the business and its success in some form. Perhaps the most high-profile piece was planned for March 30th with a one-hour ESPN special, covering the working process of the industry and some of its dark habits. Every major performer from both companies was interviewed for the show, including Bischoff and McMahon. Vince made several media appearances during the week, talking about the adult content of the company's television product with so many kids watching. In this Raw show in particular, over 2.2 million viewers were under 18, and over 3.2 million between both shows. Vince responded saying that the more edgier content is usually past 10 p.m., and that's the parents' responsibility to take care of their children. McMahon also criticized the ESPN Outside the Lines program, with Jim Ross in another interview saying that it's a clueless, asinine, self-serving piece, noting that more people watch Raw every Monday night than practically any program on their network. Kane was scheduled for a match against Goldust. Moments before it, Goldust shot a fireball at Kane and was revealed to be Triple H in a well-executed angle. Bob Holly showed up at JR's frat party, starting a wild brawl with Steve Williams all over the house. Benoit and Malenko defended the tag belts against Raven and Saturn, which originally Flair booked as a handicap match against Raven before Saturn interfered. The promoted street fight saw Shane waiting for X-Pac in the parking lot in Albany. X-Pac showed to start the brawl before Shane's posse jumped him and drove off, getting more heat for the Shane vs. X-Pac match in 6 days. Undertaker and Boss Man were scheduled to face off in a six-man tag between the Ministry and the Corporation, ending in a brawl through the crowd before the Hell in a Cell. Steiner beat Jericho to advance in the U.S. title tournament, going against a record audience on Raw. With Flair's opponent originally supposed to be the injured El Dandy, Rey Mysterio took his number to get his first ever world title match in the main event. Rey, now with high-profile push after wins over several NWO members, specifically a clean win over Nash on February 22nd, was getting a main event spotlight against Ric Flair. Unlike last week when WCW put up a big main event tag match to counter the Big Star Power tag on Raw, most of the top names already appeared on the show, going with a fresh combination of Flair vs. Mysterio. The match went 7 minutes with Flair playing his classic heel role and Rey getting a lot of the showcase moves, including having the match won when Anderson took out the ref. Continuing the tradition of spring break with Rey kicking Flair over the barricade to take a bump into the pool to close the show. With the company going all out on the promoted biggest Raw in history, the decision was made to give away on television what was at one point targeted to be saved for a major pay-per-view with the first ever Austin vs. Big Show match. A record audience was on target with every major name out for the main event and the go-home segment for WrestleMania. Raw's last quarter for the Vince and Rock introduction, along with the entrances and first half of the Austin vs. Wight match, drew a record 7.1 rating, the highest rated quarter in Raw history, and only 0.1 below the all-time Monday Night Wars record of 7.2 for the Goldberg vs. Paige Havoc match in October. The end of the match with Austin pinning Wight, along with the Rock Austin Go Home brawl, drew an all-time record 7.7 over run rating with around 8.7 million viewers, with Raw overall breaking its viewership record with a 6.4 rating. With the all-time great main event and all the programs built for months, peaking at the right time days before the show, WrestleMania by every metric is expected to set industry records in 6 days with the biggest pay-per-view of all time.